Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this quick video, I'll be showing you all about the new color wheel in Photoshop CC 2019. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. Don't forget to subscribe, and also help support my channel through Patreon. There's a link for that down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Let me first show you where you'll find the color wheel. I'll set the workspace back here to the essentials. I just reset that. There we go. There's the basic setup for the essentials. And notice the color panel is right up here. Let's just get some of this stuff out of the way. I'll minimize that right side over there and let's get the properties down. I normally work more like this with my layers panel up and then occasionally the color or the properties panel up above that. So here's your basic color panel. If you don't have this showing, just go up to the window menu and it's right there, or the F6 key. There it is. To bring the color wheel up, go over here to this little icon right there. Click on that and choose color wheel. And this brings up the new Photoshop CC color wheel. Now it's kind of small here, but it's fully functional. Let's just make it easier to see for this video. I'll just take the tab here. I'll drag the tab over into our window area, grab the bottom right corner, and we can extend this out so it's a real nice large size. And there we go. Now the main thing to see in here is that we have the hue values around the outside of the wheel. That's the wheel part of this whole thing. Inside here you have your color saturation left to right. You can see that right there. And you have your brightness up and down. Notice we also have slider controls up here. The hue is on the top, the saturation is in the middle, and the brightness is at the bottom. Now there are two little dots. There's one right there and there's one right over here that control your basic color choice. The little dot right here controls your hue. Just grab that and you can move it around. So it's just kind of following my cursor around there. So you can move that hue around that way. And this other dot, simply click into here someplace and you can move that dot around. Now this is similar. If we go over here and bring up the standard color picker, it's very similar to the color picker in the way that it works. With the color picker on the right hand side, we have our hue slider right there. This is the same thing as this color around the outside of the color wheel. We then have the saturation brightness box right here, and this part works exactly the same as the triangle works in the middle. So it's really the same control. It's just laid out a little bit differently. So if you wanted to find a color over here, you just choose your color like that. Same thing in here, just choose your color. Notice if I change my color position on the color wheel, it changes in the color picker as well. So if I go over here real bright, it changes over here. If I come down here someplace in the color picker, it does not change the color wheel. So they don't go back and forth, but whatever you choose inside of the color wheel will show up in the color picker as well. Let's go over here to a nice blue color. There we go. Again, notice how as I made a color shift over here in the color wheel, it changes in the color picker for the foreground color. Okay, let's just get that out of the way. One last little thing here though. Notice that we have all of our different ways of looking at our color here. Your hue, saturation, brightness, your RGB, your CMYK, your lab color, your hexadecimal down there. But we don't have any slider controls. You have slider controls when you're working with the color slider controls, and those are one of the options up here under the color tab. We have our sliders right there, but we have sliders in here along with the color wheel. So you can actually control your colors by your sliders. Here's the saturation slider. Notice as I move the slider, this little dot there, that color position, moves along with it. So you can choose your saturation up here and the brightness, same thing. As I pull this around, the brightness shifts as well. You can also type in your numbers up here. There's your 41% on the hue, 64%, and 77%. I guess this is the hue percentage, and this one is your saturation percentage, and this one is your brightness percentage. Now I think this is a little bit easier to understand. It seems to make more sense to me than using the standard color picker over here, which is what I normally do. I just grab this thing and use this. But I like the way that this is laid out better with the new color wheel. You can really see how the colors go clear around. It's kind of hard to understand that with the single line here on the color picker, it goes into red down here and it goes up to red up there, but you don't really get that sense that it's a continuation, which you get a much better sense here inside of the color wheel. You can also easily see complementary colors. They're straight across the wheel, just like that. Now here's our green, straight across is our magenta, right there. So you can see your complementary colors very, very easily here. You can't see that information at all over here on the standard color picker. So by having it in a wheel format, it actually is a much better way of choosing colors. But there you go. That's really all there is to it. It simply has the hue around the outside and your saturation left to right and your brightness up and down inside of the triangle in the middle. And then you have your slider controls for fine tuning. Notice up here, little icons right there. These are the same icons as we have down in the color picker area down there. Foreground color and background color. If I choose background color, I can now work on the background color. If I choose foreground color, I can work on the foreground color. So you have those options as well. And then down here in the bottom right-hand corner, little icon right here. If you find a color that you like and you want to save that for later, this will add that color over to your color swatches, which are right over in there. Notice as I'm working in here, I am seeing these different colors I've been selecting up here on the swatches automatically. This is kind of my working range right there. I'm not seeing anything that I've actually added to the swatches yet. I'll do that by clicking on this color. Say I wanted that one right there. Maybe I want the complement of that. So I'll just come straight across the circle. That's right down about here. Notice how it shows up over here in my document swatches across the top there. Let's make it a regular swatch, click on that little button right there. Give it a name, I'll just choose OK. And now if I scroll to the bottom of the swatches, we should see that there it is, right at the bottom of our swatch set as well. So there you go. That's how to work with the brand new Photoshop CC 2019 color wheel. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and share and subscribe and support my channel through Patreon. Take a look at my complete training for Photoshop, and there's a link for that right down there in the description.